Welcome to this first Axure tutorial. First, we're going to have a look at the Axure interface. So this area here contains the pages. It's basically the sitemap of your prototype. You can rename a page by clicking twice on it slowly. And if you double click, it will open the page so that you can edit it. When you open a page, it appears in a tab on top here. You can click to switch between pages as well, and the large white area here is actually the place where you'll build the layout of your page. And you'll do that using the library here. So this library contains what we call widgets. There's a very large variety of them. To add something, just drag and drop it into the work area on the right, like in the center. And let's make something by combining different types of widgets. So for example, now I'm adding a rectangle, a picture, a button, a heading, maybe a subtitle, and then some text. By default, if you take a paragraph, it will contain some lorem. So I'll just delete some of it for now. And you can resize things using the small white squares on the edges. And let's say we add a form element, for example, a checkbox. The next area below is the masters. So to create a master, it's like for the pages on top, just click on the icon with the plus and it will create a new one. But you can also select something within the page, right click, and select convert to master. Give it a name, and then we'll look at the other options later. So now that we have a master, you can see it appears red. That's how you recognize it. And you can use this as you would the widgets, except it takes the whole assembly of blocks that you made. To edit it, double click it. It will open as if it was a page in a new tab. So now you can edit this. And that's the very cool thing about masters. Let's say I want to have the checkbox next to the button. But I want this to happen on all three of my elements inside the page. So I make the change here once. And when I go back to the page, oh, it was the other one. Here you see it's been edited everywhere on all three elements. So this is very powerful when you're making templates. Now on the top right here, you have the inspector, which basically gives you style, nodes, and properties for different things. So by default, if nothing is selected, it will give you the options for the page. You can align the page differently, add a background image, decide how to display it. You also have the sketchiness option here, which basically defines how sketchy the prototype looks, like hand-drawn. You can also add a font throughout the prototype. For example, let's say I want something that looks handwritten to go with the sketchy effect. You can decide that you want a black and white color as opposed to color, and you can define the thickness of all lines in the prototype. You can add some notes to it, for example, the version or some specifications. And in the properties tab is usually where you'll manage all the interactions. You can have interactions on a page. But let's first look at how to create a simple link. Let's add a button. I want this button to link to my content page. Now to create the link, select the button, go to the link that says create link, and just select the page from your prototype sitemap. The small blue one here indicates that there is an interaction on this element, and you can read it. You also have lots of other options. By default, a link will be done on click, but you have a lot of options that we're going to explore in a later video. Next, you have the outline. The outline basically lists everything that's inside your page. So you can also group elements by selecting them, right-clicking and select group, so you'll see the group will be created inside the outline as well, and it's highlighted when you select it. This is very nice. It basically works like layers and groups in Photoshop or in a graphic design software. You can also decide to show or hide some of the elements if you want to work distraction-free, and you can search elements, which is very useful when you start to have a lot of things inside a page. Now let's look at the top bar. Here you have a bunch of shortcuts and options, which are basically style options mostly. So you can change the font, the type, the color, the size. You can also change the alignment. You notice you can't see the color right now because I said the prototype should be black and white. You can add a background color to your rectangle, add a shadow to your button. You can also control the lines. So for example, let's make them kind of dotted and then very thick and black so that they stand out. And there you go. So it's only applied to this one button. And next you have the three buttons up here, which are very important. The first one, preview, if you click on it, will allow you to see the result of your prototype inside the browser. You notice my link is working. You can highlight it using the button on the top left. So it's not actually generating the page, it just generates it on the fly every time you open it. Publish, on the other hand, allows you to generate HTML files here, or other things, just the one page, for example. For now, let's not look too much into the options. So when you do this, basically, it generates all the files into HTML in a folder. And then when you look at it, you see that it has a physical address. So this is something you can find on your computer as opposed to the preview. And you could just put this in a zip file, share it with some colleagues, or you upload it on a server. And if I make a change and reload, nothing happens. But if I do that on the preview, I'll actually, just reloading will allow me to see the changes I made. And as you notice, you see all the blocks, so hiding something in the outline doesn't actually hide it from the view once you generate the prototype. It's just for working comfort, basically. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching.